before continuing on. And I just want to share part of what he had to say about tonight's shutdown, because this is one of those circumstances where a man who obviously has experience in the Senate probably is chomping at the bit. He certainly wishes he could be there to help push this over the finish line. He's talking about what he believes is a lack of action by the Democrats. He says their action tonight, or lack thereof, is unconscionable. Our administration will do everything within our power to support the brave men and women in uniform who stand on the front lines of freedom. He goes on to add this: our administration will do everything within our power to support the brave men and women in uniform who stand on the front lines of freedom. And adding this: but as of tonight, due to a completely avoidable government shutdown, they'll stand their post without pay. And I wanted to share that because when you end up with a statement like this, you're talking about a number of people all over the globe, not just here in Washington and not just here in the United States, but are watching this. They're watching this from a very interesting perspective. They would like to know, is the leader of the free world in command of what's happening in his country? They may not understand the nuance of the power of Congress. Others from around the globe wonder, how is it that the United States can't seem to get its act together? So when you hear the vice, you would think members of the Congress could get their act together and get something done. Again, tomorrow, we'll be watching very carefully here from our perch here at the White House to see if something happens. But in the meantime, we'll be watching and waiting to see if the president perhaps takes to Twitter. I'm waiting. Aren't you waiting, Shannon?
I am, actually. I am refreshing his Twitter page and making sure we don't miss anything. All right. Kevin Corp live late into the night, early into the morning for us at the White House. Thank you so much. And we want to take you back quickly now live to the Senate floor, because it looks like conversations are continuing there. I mean, the two sides, the two leaders have come and had very tough talk for each other. But yet the conversations continue, and we see senators talking about what they're going to do next. Our understanding is that they're going to get to a voting measure eventually that would move this short-term funding measure back from February 16th, what the House passed, to February 8th is the goal now in the Senate. So let's talk about it now. Joining us now, senior columnist for Town Hall, Kurt Schlichter, and the former minority leader for the Ohio Senate, Capri Cafaro. Great to see both of you tonight.
Good morning.
Great to be here.
That's right. Good morning. We'll be
great
serving
to be
breakfast
here. Government shut down. It's great to be here.
In the meantime, it sounds like they could use them on the
Y'all show. Like and share this. Go ahead and pump it with
like,
hearts.
You know, the Senate minority leader said, we had a great meeting today. I thought I left the White House and something was going to get done. Now he says basically all hell's going to break loose because the president caved when there was pressure. What do you make of it?
I think that frankly, you know, we have separation of powers for a reason. Yes, the president of the United States does play a role in the negotiating process. But at the end of the day, members of the United States Senate and for that matter, the House have to make decisions. They're big boys and girls. And they have a job to do. So, you know, yes, they have to recognize what is the president going to sign or not sign. Certainly that has to be in their calculus. At this point, hopefully they'll be able to come to some kind of remedy within the next 24 to 48 hours, as the Senate rules, I think, allow them to do, since they have not actually closed the vote. They can go back cast a vote, because America is watching.
Yeah, and Kurt, I feel like I don't even need to ask you a question. You look like you're chomping at the bit. What are you dying to say as we watch this play out?
I'm loving this, Shannon, because we have a president who's... He's keeping his promises. He's not rolling over and doing the exact opposite of what he was elected to do. Look, this is a president who said, I'm not going to come in here and get no strings attached amnesty
DACA
to everybody who decides that, you know, wants to come to the country and vote Democrat. That's what Chuck Schumer wants. Chuck Schumer is unhappy with the American electorate. He wants to import a new one. And Donald Trump and the Republicans have said, heck no, we're not doing it. And I think it's great. And if the Democrats want to go out and say, hey, we're going to deprive America's military of what it needs to fight, and as well as what it needs to feed its family, and I was in the military when we had shutdowns in the past, in exchange for giving illegal aliens a free pass to American citizenship, that's a fight I want to have. And we're already seeing the New York Times and the AP put the blame where it belongs on the Democrats.
The Democrats shouldn't be conflating these two issues. The issue of DACA and the individuals that have come here, no fault of their own, is a matter of human dignity. But at the same time, you know, that issue is still pending until March. We have a job to do to keep the doors open. But this isn't about trying to import, you know, a new electorate for
the
Democrats.
Yes, it is. That's exactly what it is.
I don't think that's the case.
It is not even dignity. What about the dignity of American voters?
Absolutely. Look, I agree with that. And that's why I think these two issues should not be together. We need to give the DACA issue.
Oh, she's a Democrat, but she's opposed to this.
Five seconds to Kurt. I want to make sure you get a word in here.
I agree. The Democrats shouldn't have put them together. It was a tactical and strategic error.
I agree.
And I'm glad they made.
All right, thank you both for joining us tonight.
I'm kind of not glad they're made because I don't have much faith in the Republican Party.
And by the way, we will be joining the Vice President overseas. We'll be live from Jerusalem with him on Monday.
Okay, I don't know. I think they're going to shut down footage of
this. In the meantime, have a great weekend, and we'll see you for the Middle East on Monday.